Welcome, iChingus, to episode 88 of This Week in K-Pop. In this episode, we'll talk about 10 Centimeters, Dean, Eric Nam, GOT7, KittiB, Jay Park, Red Velvet, and Oh My Girl. My name is Steven, and with me is my very, very regular, he's never going to change ever again, co-host Josh.
Hello.
Now, this Week in K-Pop is a discussion podcast that covers the last two, or in this case, last 3 weeks of K-Pop music video releases. Yeah. And each week, Josh and I will choose what we think is the best song of the week.
Yeah.
But this episode, you know, if you're a new listener, you're going to want to skip maybe 10 minutes in.
Yeah.
Because we're going to spend the first 10 minutes talking about kind of like a new opportunity,
a new thing we're gonna try.
Yeah. Now this comes in direct kind of, not retaliation, I don't know what the right word is, but direct response to our last episode in the after show where we talked about kind of the future of the podcast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now I think some people misunderstood us a little bit.
I think it might have been our tone or the way that we were kind of, you know, saying things, but they kind of got the impression that we were gonna stop.
Yeah. And stop soon. Like, you know, so long story short, you know, we both live in Korea.
Yeah.
Again, if you don't know that, we both live in Korea. And we've been here for almost 3 years now.
Yeah. Come
and
August, it'll be 3 years.
Kind of time, at least for me, to think very seriously about going home.
Yeah.
And one of the main reasons why I didn't want to go home was because of this podcast, because of our YouTube channel and kind of all the work that kind of went involved, you know, up until this point, right? And I really think in the last year, it kind of changed from this hobby that I used to do that didn't take that much time off my life into something that took up a significant amount of my time, which I was fine with because I you know, liked what we were doing. But with me going home, we can't do a lot of it. But we were very clear. We were like, the podcast, we were going
to... We're gonna try and make sure the podcast
as long as possible. And one of our listeners mentioned, "Hey, why don't you guys start doing this thing called Patreon?"
And honestly, we have been thinking about doing it for a long time, but not seriously, because there have been other viewers who have said, "Hey, you should try it out," and someone else mentioned it pretty much right after that after show.
Yeah.
And so we thought, hey, you know, why not give it a shot now that...
So big news, we're going to be on Patreon.
We are.
Now, if you don't know what Patreon is a system that a lot of people... it is not like Kickstarter.
No.
But it is... That's like the closest approximation.
You could describe it as crowdfunding, but Steven and I kind of look at it more as donations.
Yeah. Kickstarter is more like you are pre-purchasing a product, which we don't have a product really. We're not selling anything.
Yeah.
That's not what this is. Patreon is pretty much we're just asking or we're hoping that you guys, our loyal listeners, will donate some money to help make kind of our dreams or your dreams even become a reality.
And we're not necessarily trying to say, hey, we want to make this, you know, our careers or anything like that. But it really would be a show of confidence for us to at least for Steven to stay in Korea another year and for us to really put a lot of effort into this podcast and try to make it the best podcast that we can make it.
Yeah, so so on Patreon, you can donate, you know, different tiers of amount of monies.
Yeah.
And, you know, if you want the specifics on that, you should go to the page that we'll link everywhere. You're going to see that page everywhere.
Yeah.
But the main point of the Patreon is for our first goal.
Yeah.
And so our first goal is a lot. This is an insane amount of money, at least in my head.
For me, when Steven and I were talking about this... we were just like, there's no way that we're gonna get this, but it's like,
but it's a number.
Why not try?
Yeah, it's a number that like we spent a lot of time thinking about, and it's a pretty big number, but it's a number that makes sense for me because this goal, this first goal, is like if we can reach this goal of $400 of donations per month, then I will stay in Korea for another year, and while that might not seem to be a huge deal, maybe to everybody else, that is a really big deal for me. Like, I enjoy Korea and I like Korea a lot, but, you know, staying in Korea doing what we do is not a permanent situation, you know, at all. And my parents would really, really love it if I could go, if I went home 2 years ago, let alone this year. And all my friends are like,
when you come
stop
back.
Being stupid and come back. You know, I'm sure you have the same
nagging kind to of. To some degree.
I mean, obviously my parents love me more than John. I'm just kidding. That's not true. it might even be the opposite of like, my parents are like, have no faith in me and really want me to go home and
so they continue can keep a watchful my life. Eye.
Yeah. So, you know, $400,
yeah.
You know, is a good show of confidence of like, we have enough viewer support that I can justify kind of spending another year of my life in Korea with Josh doing the podcast, right? That's the whole point, is that I can be with Josh. We can continue the podcast, you know, as it is now.
Yeah. And in the same vein, with those $400 a month, it's not just going to be for Steven to stay. We are going to invest that $400 back into the podcast by trying to get better lighting. So Steven and I are kind of upset about the quality of our kind of video podcast because our video podcast, we feel we have a pretty good camera, but the lighting and kind of color correction is a problem. Yeah. And so we do want to
put it's also a problem that I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. So
neither of us
I bought a camera that like I bought a Lumix GH4, which was way more expensive than I probably should have for what we do. And yeah, I'm always fretting on like, why does our podcast not look as good as some of the other ones?
And blah, blah, blah. Or some other videos that we noticed.
Yeah. And I really do think lights is one part of it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to use that $400, you know, for other things like lights. We're also going to like, if we can reach that goal, we're also going to record an extra podcast per month.
I would call it a mini podcast.
Yeah. We're shooting for maybe 30 minutes, 45 minutes of a podcast where Patreon supporters can kind of help us decide what that podcast will be.
Yeah.
Like the theme of that podcast.
Mm-hmm. And we've done similar podcasts like this before where we've talked about, you know, like some top tens or maybe we talk about some album reviews. Those are just some examples of what that podcast could entail. But it really will be up to our Patreon supporters and what they want to see.
Yeah, if you guys want to see like the best five songs, you know, coffee sounding song, coffee shop songs, or the best five summer jams, we got that. You the best five ballads that we can think of, we got that.
Yeah, like, top five music videos with a floppy hat, you got it.
We got it. Well, we're not gonna do that.
I don't want to do that.
What kind of podcast would that be? Like, this one has a floppy hat that you can't see at all.
I don't want to do that.
Great suggestion, Josh. But there's also things like maybe we can do an FAQ podcast where we get all the questions from our Patreon supporters. That's really one of the, you know, hopefully one of the rewards or benefits you get for supporting us on Patreon. You can help us decide on some of these extra podcasts and extra things.
Mm-hmm.
And also part of the $400, we also want to put the podcast on SoundCloud, which is something that a couple of viewers have asked. Mm-hmm. But I also think that I don't personally use SoundCloud ever.
I don't use SoundCloud except for the rare occasion.
Except for when we want to find that Rick and Morty Rick and Morty podcast song.
Get Swifty.
Something remix.
Yeah. And Dromulus
remix.
Yeah.
Like that song is amazing. But we mentioned it before. So I don't really use SoundCloud.
No, neither.
But I do know that a lot of people use SoundCloud. A lot of other podcasts put their podcasts on SoundCloud. And so, you know, but SoundCloud also costs money.
Yeah.
So, you know, we think that's a really good way to give you guys an extra option of listening to us if you're not, you know, if you don't want to listen to us on YouTube or on whatever podcasting platform you use.
Because there are a lot of viewers who are not sure about how to, like, listen to our podcast or watch our podcast besides, you know, YouTube or iTunes. Yeah. And we're trying to, you know, broaden our venues.
Yeah. Yeah. And this will hopefully also make us bigger, you know, with more people might discover us on SoundCloud and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So that's our first kind of main goal, that $400, which again is an insane amount of money.
I think it's really crazy.
But with $400 a month, I think, we can, you know,
we could do a lot.
That's like I would if we can reach that, I would cry. I would probably cry because that's like
I would be flabbergasted. Like I. Yeah,
I would cry. Josh is just going to be flabbergasted. But,
I would. Like, well, that would rarely, be amazing. I rarely without a loss of words.
That is true. You talk.
I talk a lot.
Like, all the time.
Yeah.
Like, even when I don't want you to, you talk.
Dumb shit.
But, you know, there are more goals kind of past that that we're looking for.
Yeah.
Like, for example, one of the goals that we're thinking of is bringing back K-pop sins, which is something that I did on our YouTube channel.
Kind of for fun, to be honest.
Yeah, for fun. Yeah. And I only did it for like 2 weeks, and I released like 7 episodes. But a lot of people have been asking about, you know, when's K-pop sins coming back?
Do K-pop sins for this. I think it'd be really funny.
Yeah. And so we think that's a really good way to, again, broaden our channel with the help of you guys. Mm-hmm. And also the Patreon supporters can help choose which songs that I'll do for K-pop sins.
Yeah.
Another goal, of course, is lights will help us with our video podcast.
Yeah.
But we haven't really upgraded the audio part of our podcast.
Yeah, for a while.
For a long time. Yeah. We actually kind of downgraded it going to our current setup with the nice camera because we use a totally different mic.
Yeah.
But, you know, another goal would be to buy actual real kind of XLR mics with a mixer and record the podcast a lot better audibly.
That would very much increase the audio part quality of our podcast.
Yeah. And kind of our highest, like, pie in the sky goal right now is if we can reach that, which we don't have a number for yet, but it would be to bring back the K-pop weekly update.
Yeah.
That we know there's like a set 200 of you guys that watch really the shit it. Out of the really K-pop weekly update.
And
nobody else did.
And honestly, Steven and I, we really do love doing the K-pop weekly update, but it is an immense amount of work for Steven because of the editing, and it's just a lot of manpower and a lot of man hours.
Yeah, it might take more man hours to do the weekly update than the podcast with like a tenth of the amount of watching or listening, right?
Yeah.
So we would love to do it, but I was really hesitant about ever asking for money on this podcast because I feel really bad about it. I still feel bad about it. You know, doing this Patreon, we're asking for like your hard earned money that you know.
I mean, even if it's like a dollar, like it's the principle of asking for the money that is, it's not only the monetary value. It's like the
expectations, I think, also. Like, there's some kind of burden, you know, that is involved in that. Like, you know, and we have talked about this at length of, like, because that's why this podcast, well, part of the reason this podcast is a week late is because we spent a lot of time talking about, like, the response to our future video. It was like, man, all these people are saying all these things. Like, what should we do to kind of help the podcast remain the quality that it is, and this was kind of our solution.
And for a long time we have like talked about, you know, Patreon, and we have talked about like different kind of ideas, and I mean, I guess the reason we're doing Patreon now is because we feel like well this is like a last ditch effort to kind of maintain the quality
of
the podcast that we want to put out.
But we want to be clear though, like if this Patreon doesn't work out, we are still making the podcast.
We will not stop the podcast, but there probably will be a noticeable drop in quality.
Yeah. If I go home.
If Steven goes home.
Which again, even if this doesn't work out, I do not go home until the end of August anyways. Yeah. So there's still 5 months or 4 months of the podcast as is normally, no matter, right?
But the reason why we do feel kind of pressured is because Steven will have to decide come May.
Yeah.
So that gives us about a month of time to talk more in depth about what we're going to do.
Yeah. And so, you know, if you want the full details of everything, you should go to the Patreon page. Yeah. You should sign up and hopefully donate some money if, you know, all the hours, you know, maybe because I listen to a lot of podcasts. And like, you know, I remember one day realizing like I have listened to this podcast for 4 years, right? I've probably, you know, that's many, many, many hours of my life that this is like free entertainment,
hours,
right? It's not like it's not like YouTube where at least like you get a little bit of ad money, right? When you watch somebody's channel on YouTube, like I'm watching completely for free. This dude, these people talk, you know, like, so I finally was like, I should donate money because like, this is like,
you feel invested.
I feel invested and like, you know, like they have done it for so long for free. Yeah. Like I was like, that's a lot of content. So what we're trying to say is, I try to go a roundabout way of not trying to sound selfish because that's like the problem with this, right? It's like, I'm afraid we're going to sound like selfish and we're in it like for the money.
How dare these guys ask for money? Butter. Don't they have like day jobs or whatever? That is, I guess, partly a problem with starting it before, but Patreon, we're mainly looking for a vote of confidence.
And that vote of confidence will help us make it better. We're not just gonna take that money and spend it on strippers and fucking
and
blue,
booze and
right?
blackjack.
Yeah. Blackjack would be nice. Right. We're doing this to make it better for you guys and hopefully give you guys bonus content. And you know, some of the rewards are you know, seem kind of simple, but really like the reward, you know, is like we are all gonna help each other make what we do better, right? Yeah. And last longer, right? Yeah. But you know, for $10 a month, you get access to what we're calling Chingu Chat, which I think is my favorite reward.
It's definitely my favorite as well.
And what that is we're going to use, it's a chat program. It's called Slack. Mm-hmm. And it's something that I use personally with my friends, but it's actually designed for, workplaces, right?
Yeah. But and it's not a plug. It's not a plug.
No. Although it's a great program. Yeah. But like, you know, because we heard so much stuff of like, I'm the only person that I know that knows anything about K-pop, and that's why I listen to your podcast. And like, we knew that, but we kind of didn't know that, which was like, because we were kind of complaining about like, oh man, our podcast is not growing that much, you know, and it totally makes sense that it wouldn't grow very fast because the only people that would find us or want to listen to us are people that don't have anybody else to talk about with. Yeah. Which means they don't have anyone to share it with, which means they don't have anybody to like pass on the podcast to, right?
Yeah. And with that desire to kind of like be those chingus for you to talk to about K-pop, we're making this Chingu Chat.
Yeah, because we do a lot of discuss. We call it a discussion podcast, but we're not really discussing it with you guys. You guys are listening to our discussion.
Yeah.
But using this thing of like you get access to our Slack server. Our Chingu Chat, I guess, is what we're calling it.
Chingu Chat.
So that not only can you talk to us using Chingu Chat, but you can also talk to other people that hopefully donate money and are in our kind of Chingu family.
Yeah.
And so that you'll be able to talk to other people about K-pop, which is, I think, what you guys want and what we want. Slack is amazing because you can have separate channels. So you can have like the boy group channel, the girl group channel.
BTS channel.
So like... you know, it's not like Facebook Messenger or Kakao that we use where like it's very one-on-one. It's like a group chat. Like this is like specifically designed for multiple people to talk about multiple things without being bogged down by other things. It's really great. So hopefully we can see a lot of you guys be nice enough and kind enough to donate $10 per month and get access to Chingu Chat. But, you know, there's much more, you know, even at $2 a month, you're 100% helping us with kind of... our dreams, I guess.
Our dreams.
But that's enough talking about Patreon. We're not going to spend, you know, we're not going to do this every podcast.
No.
So
this is the first week that we've decided, okay, we're going to try to do it. So we just want to give you a basic rundown of what we're planning and where things kind of stand right now.
Yeah. And so the links will be in the descriptions. I'm pretty sure it's just www.patreon.com/thisweekinkpop.
Yeah, it's probably going to be.
But we're actually, I need to set this up right after recording.
Yeah, like we literally, before we started recording this, we just decided on what we're...
what all the reward tiers and all that stuff is. Because it's so like hard to decide all that stuff.
Because Steven and I, we're the type of people who really hate asking for help. Like if there's something that we can do on ourselves, even though it takes us like 10 hours to do by ourselves, or we could have done it 1 hour asking someone else, we are very stubborn in that sense.
I know I shouldn't, but I really want to tell this story. But there's this story of like as a person, I just hate asking for help, right?
Yeah,
even when the solution would be so easy to just ask for help, I like refuse to do it, right? And it's not even because like it's a man thing. I just don't.
No.
I don't want people to see that I failed. Okay? It's like a not. It's like a self-confidence problem, yeah. Right?
For me, it's a different reason, but okay. I'm in the same vein.
That's my reason. Mm. And so one time I was, I don't actually know if I told the story. One time I was with my parents. We were in California visiting family friends.
Okay.
And, you know, it was late at night. I went to take a shit. And I clogged up their toilet.
Oh, I heard this story before. Go on.
Did I tell on the podcast?
You've told me before.
Okay. Well, like, instead of just like, because it was late at night, I didn't want to wake anybody up, and I also didn't want to admit my stinky poops clogged up this toilet. Yeah. I was like, I'm not going to ask for help. I'm going to try and unclog this toilet by myself. But I was young and stupid. And so, like, I didn't just like, I couldn't find a plunger.
Yeah.
So, like, I don't even remember exactly what I did, but in the end, I ended up using towels. I don't know why towels.
You thought they would be suction.
I thought I could maybe like grab it and like move it away, right? And like I was trying to use the towels to kind of unstuff the podcast, or not the podcast, the toilet. So what happened is by the time it was all said and done, not only had I ruined multiple towels with shit, okay, with my dirty shit and pee because they're just peeing there, Like the bathroom was ruined. Like everything was ruined. All I had to do was just ask for help from even my mom. I didn't even have to ask the lady's help, the lady who owns the house. Or I could have just asked my mom and woke her up. But I was just like, I'm just not gonna ask for help. And like that kind of self-confidence problem manifests with this thing because it's like, oh man, what if we ask for money and we get like $2, right? Like that's like, you know, that's like a legit fear of mine of like. Like, oh man, like people don't like us, you know, that much, right? But as you said, like this is kind of our last shot, right? Our last chance of like, this is the only way we thought that I would feel comfortable staying a whole nother year. And also once we get past goal number one, like goal number 2, 3, 4, and 5 will legitimately make the podcast better. And like
even goal number one makes it.
And you even mentioned like, you know, we can't do this for a job, but like it is our dream goal if we could like sufficiently supplant our main income sources and like
that'd be ridiculous.
Make podcasts for life, but that would never happen because we would need what like $7,000 a month, because that's how much we kind of make between us, teaching right now. Between the two of us. But anyways, holy shit, that was a long time. Let's get started with the podcast.
Let's do it.
This episode,
a little bit long.
I think we're actually relatively different this episode because there was no song this week where I was like, this is a great song. Like, I thought we had a lot of decent, okay songs this week, but there was no song where I was like, you know, hot damn, like, I'm gonna turn this motherfucker out, you know?
So I have maybe, like, one or two songs that I feel like, oh, hot damn, these are pretty good songs, but majority of the songs we're talking about this week, I think, are about 7 and 8.
Like, I think this is, like, I think the overall average quality this week is okay, but I think that average quality is less than a lot of our podcast episodes this year. Like we've downloaded a lot of songs this year.
Pretty good podcasts up until this point. Yeah.
But anyway, so the first song that I want to talk about was just released 2 days ago.
Yeah.
Or maybe one day ago.
Yeah.
And
depending on
where you at right now in the time zone universe. It's by a Korean favorite kind of indie duo.
Yeah.
And we've talked about them before. They're 10 centimeters. With their new song, What is Spring?
Yeah.
Yeah, so as Steven said, 10 Centimeters is a duo, and the best way we can describe them is they're kind of like Death Cab for Cutie.
It's called What the Spring.
What the Spring.
What the Spring! Like, what the funk.
Yeah, this duo is very, very, very famous in Korea. I think every Korean knows them almost, but they are still considered indie.
Yeah. But, I mean, they have a very specific... This is, like, one of those things where, like, you see on, like on Tinder, if they're a college-age student, they're like, man, I love 10 Centimeters. That's, like, the cool group to like when you're, like, in college.
Yeah, and 10 Centimeters, they're known mainly for their acoustic sound. Yeah. And right now, their song is number one on at least Melon on the charts. And it came out maybe, as we said, a day or two ago.
Yeah, like this is a... And what's so great about this song is because, you know, this time, it's springtime. It's just becoming spring. Yeah. It is all about kind of ballady love songs. Yeah. Right?
Like, the songs that make you feel good, like duets.
And, yeah. Like that Busker Busker song, despite being released a million years ago.
Like 3 or 4 years ago, is now like number 9
on the charts. It comes back top 10 every single year because that's the time of year. And this is the anti-spring song, okay? Yeah. It is super sarcastic. And like, honestly, if this song was in English, I think this would have been like a number 10 for me, right? Mm. Like because when I'm reading the lyrics along with the music video, like... That's great, right? Mm. But I don't really feel the snarkiness, right? Because it's in Korean.
So, like, since I do understand a Korean, like, a good amount, like, and reading kind of, like, the Korean lyrics of it, the snarkiness and the sarcasticness is so much more intense in the Korean version than it is in the English translation in the music video. Yeah. So,
But, like, let's say you're an audio listener, right? You just heard the song, right? Yeah. Like, give us an example, like, why is this an anti-spring song, Josh?
Yeah. So first, the name of the song in English is What the Spring. Mm-hmm. And just hearing What the Spring, you don't really know what it really kind of entails in terms of
feeling, it could just be a really bad English translation.
Yeah, right. But the Korean title is like Bomi Monya, which means like what's so good about spring or why is spring so great? So that's already really sarcastic, right? Yeah. Like really snarky. And like an example is like he will say something like, oh, you know, your boyfriend likes games better than you. And that's kind of like an insult, right? Yeah. But then the snarkiness of that line is like, oh, your very sweet, kind, caring boyfriend says he wants to go to a PC bong because he's too tired.
Yeah. And the best part, it's like it's sung like a sweet love song.
Yeah.
And he's got such an amazing voice and the acoustic guitar, it matches perfectly.
Yeah.
It's kind of like it would be like a parody. It's pretty much like a parody song, right?
Yeah.
Where it's just like, oh, like you guys think you're happy now. You think you guys love each other.
But just like cherry blossoms fall to the ground. You guys are going to fake fucking up.
Yeah. It is. It's fucking hilarious,
it's amazing,
right?
Yeah.
Like, and you know, but not only that, like the song itself is still a great song.
Still really good. Really, really catchy.
Yeah.
So it has like all of the goodness of like a spring kind of love song or whatever, or acoustic song, like a Busker Busker cherry blossom ending. But it is so just fun.
Yeah.
It's just so fun.
And I wish, right? I wish I understood it, right? Because like, you know, if I download this song and I'm listening to it on the street, I'm not really smirking to myself because I'm not really understanding what he's saying, right? Like, I really wish that, like, I could be walking down the street and I see this happy couple over there. This song comes on and I'm just like,
you motherfuckers.
I hope you fucking people break up because I'm lonely and I'm sad and I hate y'all. But that's, like, what this song is, right?
In an extra place.
I'm sorry, man.
I'm lonely and I'm sad and I hate you.
But that's what the song is, right? The song is literally just like, I'm, like, what's so good about spring? Like, you're going to be alone one day, just like me. So
like the one critique I have about the music video, not the song, but the music video, is that Steven and I, when we watched it, we knew that it was really, really snarky, really, really sarcastic. But the music video is this weird CG, like kind of half like CG, half like...
Just his face.
His face. And Steven and I, we would have loved it if this music video was like I can imagine just like you know, his guitarist like following him while he's singing in the street, and then he like will see a couple or something who are like planning to go to the movies and have like a box of a bowl of popcorn or something, and he like knocks the popcorn out of the ground.
Yeah,
like that would be so freaking hilarious.
Like they could have made a video where it's more like Gangnam Style, where it's funny and it and like it,
there's a lot of potential.
There's a lot of potential there. Like this could have been a song where like, man, you guys should check out. When I say you guys, I mean like American people or anyone not Korean, be like, look at this hilarious, like, anti-love song. Yeah.
Like, song. It would have been really, like, if I had, honestly, if I had that music video, this song might even have been, like, top 10 for me. Mm. Like, this song is really, really good. I was planning to pick it as my number one, but this week I did want to talk about a lot of different songs, so.
Also because I didn't really like any of his songs. I kind of took this one. Yeah.
So, I mean, in that same vein, I want to talk about the song that I chose for this week as my number one, and that is Dean featuring Gecko from Dynamic Duo with Half Moon.
An up-and-coming producer. We talked about him many episodes ago.
Producer turned singer now.
Yeah, like, I mean, he had Pour Up, which we both liked. He also was featured in a lot of things that we talked about.
Yeah.
But, you know, finally I looked him up, and, like, he did produce and or write lyrics for a lot of boy groups, you know.
Yeah.
EXO, VIX, Madtown, Unique Speed. Yeah. You know, he's very much like Crush, who used to be behind the scenes a lot and is now stepping up.
Yeah.
And even Zion T used to be behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Now he... floppity hat stepping out.
And I'm glad Korean R&B is taking that route, because that happens a lot, I think, in like Western music, where a producer who can sing starts, you know, making his own music or her own music, and they become pretty successful.
Like, see, I know this. Like Kanye West.
Kanye West
used to be like the behind the dude, writing lyrics for other dudes, and he was like, fuck that shit.
Yeah,
I can do better.
And like Pharrell used to be a producer as well. Oh, Robin Thicke. A lot, like, the list goes on and on and on, and Korea is following in that trend, and which what really, like, just kind of blows my mind is I think Dean is so handsome, and that he could have been a singer no problem, but he decided to produce instead.
I don't think he's that handsome, but...
But he's pretty handsome, though.
I mean, he's definitely more handsome than fucking Zion T, right?
Okay, yeah, right. He's handsome enough to be a popular singer, is what I'm trying to say. Like, he doesn't got producer face. Don't got radio face. You know?
I guess.
Yeah.
Or maybe, you know, he had a problem like Bean Zeno had a problem, where everyone didn't take him seriously because he looked so pretty. I don't know.
Maybe. So the reason why I kind of want to talk about this song over like 10 centimeters is because Dean has put out an album, and I have been listening to it pretty religiously for the past week. So the album's called 130 Mood Treble.
Treble spelled T-R-B-L.
And there's like a semicolon in there, and it's nice. But anyways,
maybe this is why he's not popular. He's fucking naming his shit broken as fuck.
Just trying to look at the album. Another song on that album that he released a music video for is called Bonnie and Clyde.
I know. 여기까지 깼니 오늘 너의 하루는 어땠니 아무 일도 없긴 뭐가 없어 가끔 오해만 나를 해도 꽤 쉽지만은 나는 게 있어 I know no 다 안다고 내 앞에서 아닌 척해도 Body cry body cry 오늘 후 계속 계속 친구 사이
Better.
Yeah, I like Bonnie and Clyde more than Half Moon, but they're both very, you know, if you did listen to Pour Up, it's very in the same vein of both of those songs where it's like really slow R&B, but not ballady, right?
Yeah.
But not, it's not that going hard kind of R&B, right? It's not brand new music R&B. It's not AOMG R&B. It's like its own separate Dean R&B.
Yeah, it's kind of like a baby making R&B. And so in that same vein, the album is very similar in that way. Dean definitely has a certain style he likes to like produce songs in and sing songs in. And a lot of those songs on the album might sound similar. Mm-hmm. But for me, that's like my kind of pocket pick. I really like that kind of music. I really like Dean's voice, his producing style. So this album is really, really great for me. And if your taste kind of aligned with my taste, go check out the album. You will not be disappointed.
Yeah. But for the record, I did like Pour Up more than Josh in the beginning. I remember
that. That's true. Clearly. Yeah, that's true.
So you know I got taste too, okay? They're not just all girl groups. Well, speaking of girl groups, normally we would take a break here to kind of thank people and read things, but we already spent a lot of time on Patreon, so we're going to save that for the second half.
Yeah.
But yeah, speaking of girl groups, the next song that I want to talk about is by a group called Oh My Girl with their new song, Liar Liar.
Pants not on fire. Oh my girl.
Except my pants are on fire watching this video. Whoa! Just kidding. Actually, that's not true at all. That is not true at all. Now, Oh My Girl is the sister girl group to B1A4, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, B1A4.
Now that I see, it's B1A4, definitely B1A4. And I remember this group because one of my students is like a B1A4 like fanatic, right?
Yeah.
And so when Oh My Girl started, she's like one of my favorite students. When Oh My Girl came out, she was like, she already had...
I have to support
her. Yeah, she bought everything. She spent like $60 buying the CD, buying the t-shirt, buying the this. I'm like, do you even know anything about them? They're like, no, but they're B1A4 sister coming. I got to support them, right? And I remember their first song came out and...
Closer.
That's not their first song.
What's the first song?
Their first song was...
That song.
I don't know what it's called. Doesn't matter. But, like, that song, like, despite that part being really catchy, like, I just really didn't like that song. And I used to, like, make fun of her all the time because she was like, it's a great song. It's a great song. And I'm like, is it a really great song? And she's like, no. So a lot of times, like, that's sad. That shit, right? But then Closer came out, and, like, I really liked Closer. Way more than Josh liked Closer.
Yeah, way more.
But, like, I thought it was such a, it was, like, such a unique sounding ballad song, like especially for this like F-tier kind of, well not F-tier, sorry,
but like a relatively
B-tier, C-tier unknown girl group.
Yeah,
because usually they come out with the flavor of the flavor of the month kind of style, because you need to match what's currently popular. And and Oh My Girl did something totally different. And long roundabout way of saying Liar Liar for me is very similar to Closer, where it sounds they're not close together sounding, but they're both songs that like sound very different than what's coming out normally.
Yeah.
And like, you know, it's not the best song in the world, but like, I really enjoy my time with Liar Liar when I'm listening to it. Mm. Really enjoy it. Like, it has this kind of like we intend to sham heart. That is way more like marching band, like chanting style. But like that kind of like pushing forward, like da 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 da. Like this song has its version of that.
It's very rhythmic, like kind of like drum, like kind of bass, like pounding.
Like it reminds me of why we both like the at least the beginning part of AOA Cream's song, because it's like it's so like bopping my head and we're going forward. And now that I can't even remember what Liar Liar sounds like because of this fucking first song, but like it just. It brings me along the entire time. Because one of my big pet peeves with girl group songs and boy group songs is that they're boring 90% of the time. Mm. Like, they might have a catchy chorus, but the build up to the chorus is boring. The verse is boring and generic.
Yeah.
And like, that's why I like Brave Sound, because Brave Sound does a great job of not making the entire song boring.
Yeah, they add a little bit of those like little flares in there, like claps or like hey, or like something
in there. And Liar Liar doesn't do the Brave Sound thing. It's its own kind of thing for me, but like it has that like, I'm always engaged in this song, and that is the best thing I can possibly say about a song.
Yeah.
Also, it's a DigiPetty video, but not the normal. I think there's like two levels of DigiPetty.
Yeah.
There's the we don't have that much money DigiPetty, so it's a lot of like just a back screen,
simple props, and
like up and down is like a not very EX80s, you know, or which one's the last one we talked about? Yeah, the song's called Rainbow. Jesus. But like that song was like one of the cheap versions, but this one is like one of the more expensive versions where it's not just a background. It's like they actually built a set and like they're actually like walking around and doing things, and there's a lot of like
The colors are very, very kind of, they really, really scream DigiPenny.
I mean, that's how I knew to Google it, right? But you know, I feel like never underestimate how great a DigiPenny music video is, right? It's often simplistic, but it lets you focus on the members, it lets you focus on the song, and it puts a little bit of quirkiness to where you're where you're engaged the whole time.
Yeah.
And you know, there's no dancing, which kind of sucks because I would like to see some dancing, but for what it does, I think it's you know,
DigiPenny's really strength as a music video making company is being very kind of clear, but at the same time, very quirky.
Moving on.
So the next song that I want to talk about is by our rapper friend, KittiB, featuring Verbal Jint with Doing Good.
Yeah. 자고 잘 것 없었지 봐봐 I'm doing good, doing, doing good I'm doing good, doing, doing good, yeah 나도 처음이야 너를 만나 어느 병가 더뎌지고 물러질 뻔하지지 않는 내 성장 네 멋대로 바꾼대도 그저 맞추기에 바빴던 내 태도 인정은 하기 싫지만 내 맘이 더 커 약자가 됐던 그때를 기억해 you said 넌 안 돼 But I told you that I got this someday 네 옆에 있는 내 모습을 미워해 내가 날 싫어해 그래도 날 믿어 멀어 있던 눈을 떠 내 자신에게 띄웠던 무릎표 거둘 거야 그 누구도 날 무너뜨릴 순 없어 우리 만남에 부를 거 소방관은 아니 지만 이제 난 진화해 다른 이들로부터 더 이상 내 모습을 찾지 않게 집중해 비춰봐 미러 그 안에서 있는 널 믿어 I will win it all 남자 말고 이제 내게 시간 내 아닌 nothing I'm doing 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 good, good. I'm doing 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 good, good. I'm doing 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 good, good. 나를 믿어 너 없이 잘하고 있어 I'm doing 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 good
I never would have called KittiB our friend.
Well, everyone's our friend.
Everyone's
our
your friend.
Friend.
Chingu our
friend.
Listeners are our friends.
Our Chingu J Park. Our Chingus. Oh my girl.
These are all things you say. I don't say those things.
I think it's because it's a very Korean thing to say. Like, if they're like referring to someone, like, ah, oh, this friend is something, something, something.
Maybe, but I'm not Korean, nor do I know Korean, so that's why I never say it.
Maybe it's a Korean habit of mine.
But Josh is so Korean that... No. I don't even know where I was going with that. Yeah. There were some racist things I was thinking about in my head, but I'm not going to go. Anyways, so KittiB, if you don't know, she was in I'm Pretty Rap Star 2. But after I'm Pretty Rap Star 2, she joined Brand New Music, which I actually didn't know until I looked it up. And she works for this song with Brand New Music producer... Ass brass.
That's a funny way of saying fart. Got some ass brass coming your way.
No, it wasn't that funny the first time you said it, and now that you said it again, it's really that funny. Sorry, Josh.
Oh, you're such an asshole.
You're an ass brass, all right?
but Brandy Music is really famous for artists, you know, like Sani.
Verbal Gent. Phantoms.
Right. A lot of really big hitters in the Korean hip-hop scene. And KittiB is kind of adding the female version flair of that. And in this kind of whole song, I think it kind of has the Gaiyan's like fuck you kind of concept where KittiB is probably rapping about a maybe previous experience of an abusive relationship and how she's out of it now and she's doing good. Yeah. She's a better person now and you fucked up and she maybe wasn't, you know, being really smart while she was dating this guy, but now she's a better person because she persevered.
And yeah, we had a lot to say about that Gaiyan's fuck you when it came out, and how like we thought. I remember getting a lot of downvotes of how like it was a really bad example of like domestic violence and like blah 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 blah. And like, but this I think is a really good like.
Yeah.
It seems really personal, and it seems like this song was written for that reason.
Yeah,
Gaiyan's fuck you I think was like. Not really written for that reason, and they just concept roped it into that.
Gaiyan's was like more kind of risque, like, and the tone of the song was also kind of like really confusing, really ambiguous. But KittiB, this song, the tone, the way she raps, her storytelling is all about like, yeah, dated this guy, he was an asshole, but I'm good now. Fuck that guy.
Yeah, like I'm an individual. Now. I'm strong. And I'm
I don't need no man. Yeah. I'm strong. Like. If you are looking for a female empowerment video and just like kind of a video or a song that's like, you know, fuck abusive relationships, this song's for you.
I mean, you're not going to understand if you don't know Korean, but even besides that, like, but I think her rapping...
I think the video does have English captions, though.
It does, but, you know, you're supposed to listen to the song.
That's true.
But, you know, we talked a lot about the concept of the song and the story, but like I think the actual song and her actual rapping is pretty okay. I mean, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
I
very much enjoyed it. I thought her rapping was very good.
Which is weird because like in On Pretty Rap Star 2, I didn't really like KittiB that much.
Yeah.
And she's been in some other rando songs since On Pretty Rap Star 2, and I didn't really think they were that good.
Yeah.
But like, I guess with the with Ass Brass kind of like pushing her, like I thought. I mean, it worked really well, especially for the beat of the song. I think the beat of the song is usually brand new music is like, that's their thing though. It's like they make a really great kind of backing track.
Yeah.
And I think they did a really good job with the song.
And I really enjoy more like rap where they're either rapping about a story or they're rapping about an experience in their life or maybe like some obstacle they've overcome.
Right. Not money, bitches, hoes, fucking. Right?
Yeah, like, like, for example, like Sani. Sani in the same group of Brand New Music. When Sani raps about kind of like a situation or like a...
Or love or flirting.
Or an experience or... that like, he's probably had. Like, I think his rapping is so much better than just like, I'm fucking Sani, I'm the best, right? And KittiB, I felt like kind of had that problem in Unpretty Rap Star 2 and some of the songs that she's released, that she's more of kind of like a bravado rapper. But... this song is, I think, very, it probably hits very close to home for her. And for that reason, I think she probably rapped much better than any of the other ones I've heard.
Yeah, I mean, I don't, I can't even recall what she even rapped about because it was so lackluster to me. But like, I think if we're like, you know, best female rapper, that song that I've heard, you know, in a long, in a good long while, like KittiB is definitely... this, this song is definitely, one of the best ones.
One of the best I've heard in a while.
And there's been a lot of it, you know, especially, you know, even though we love Puss because it's hilarious and the backing track of that is awesome.
We love like, the
that's
instrumental.
That's not a great rap. G-Min is not a great rapper, okay? Like, hands down, she ain't a great rapper.
Lyrically,
she does her job well.
Lyrically, that song, F.
but totally,
that song, D.
Okay. Wow, you think lyrically is worse than her tone?
I mean, I
think a lot of people would disagree with that.
My ears are calloused to her rapping style.
But, like, I enjoy that song, right, for what it is. But, like, I think this song is definitely the best example of, like, in our after show, which we're not going to record until next week, but our after show is primarily going to be about Produce 101.
Yeah.
Which is a song, which is a series that... I have tried to stay away from until for a very long time.
I
refused to watch that show until one of our mutual friends was like, you need to fucking watch that show.
Jessica, what's up?
Yeah, she's not watching this.
Definitely not.
And the reason I mention that is because the people who make Produce 101 made Unpretty Rap Star 2, made Show Me the Money. And like, you know, Show Me the Money 5 or whatever the number was. Four. Show Me the Money 4 and Unpretty Rap Star 2. Like, nothing really came out of either
of
those.
And the cutting was really, really terrible. The storytelling was really, really terrible. So.
But they're always terrible. But usually, at least the songs are good. And, like, but Unpretty Rap Star 2 especially, like, none of those girls really did anything.
No.
And so I think this is the best song I've heard from anyone on Unpretty Rap Star 2.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah.
Look forward to that Produce 101 talk because I have. We were just talking about how crazy it is that I watched all 10 episodes of it in like three days. We were like thinking like, how much time did you even like taking out time for work, taking out time for sleeping? Like, I pretty much did only Produce 101 for
three days. You only pooped and watched Produce 101.
I mean, yeah. Sometimes I wouldn't even poop because I wanted to finish the episode.
Wow.
You know. But anyways, that's it for part one, a very long part. Please, of course, you know, stay with us for part two where we talk about some of just kind of discussion songs, right? May not be our most favorite songs, but at least definitely some famous people songs that we want to talk about.
And audio listeners, just stay tuned after
Stay tuned because you're stuck with us. Sucks to be y'all. All right, part two. We're going to start with two of Josh's songs that he picked for this discussion period. So Josh, what songs be those?